In today's video, I'm decided to show you this book. This is about Denmark. It says known Danish writers about their places in Denmark. So, and in the beginning, I found this randomly very nice, very nice magazine with a super crinkly rich material. But I really enjoyed it, so I decided to put the beginning. And in this video, I'm going to chew the gum. So, and I think this video is not going to be the fast because I really wanna show you the pictures of Denmark, and it's gonna be my first time and I'm gonna see these images as well. And actually I wanted to show you the book of Lithuania, but I couldn't find it in the library here. But then I will go back home. I'm going to pick some books about my country, and I would be really happy to show you. So, let's begin with this old magazine of letters. This magazine is from 1997, October. We have a lot of whiteness and so on, but now this shop is mostly for the shampoos and other things. So probably back in the time, later with a bit slightly different focus. I really enjoy this page structure. This boy is like typical that time space face. Mid Denmark. Why Denmark? Denmark has a lot of beautiful places. It doesn't have mountains or high hills. More like flat, but it has a lot of nice areas. Really, really beautiful beaches. They are very clean and they have white structure. Unfortunately, I cannot see the descriptions. That's probably two of the pictures I'm going to recognize. Denmark is a very, very peaceful country. Actually, this one reminds me of the place where I live nearby. I go here for jogging or ride a bicycle. And here, not here, but in that place, there are big wall there. I go to chill. My city, Aalborg, it was known a few years ago as the happiest city in the world or in Europe, I don't remember. It was actually, it is. People are very polite here and nice. The houses has very unique structure and architecture. People love to have summer houses. And also they have a lot of green fields where they have horses. And you see boats, because there are a lot of water and people enjoy chilling on the boat and traveling around. Some people even live there. I meet a lot of horses. Even the animals are very friendly here. But people usually don't have so many dogs or cats, or neither you can see like dog or cat going running around in the streets, because having an animal here is quite expensive and you have to be sure that he has all the vaccines and everything, so it's kind of expensive thing. People really love animals here and appreciate them. And this country is very well in economics, so they have a lot of buildings, infrastructure, and all the things inside. Unfortunately, I cannot see what is written here because I want to show you the images. It will take my time, but I'm gonna read it again. Don't worry. Here, the main streets look like this. Many of the cities has the same architecture of the streets, the style of the streets. And yeah, Denmark is well known as the bicycle country. If you go to Copenhagen, you will see so many cyclists that you never seen in your entire life. For me also, I like to ride the bike a lot. This is my main transport, especially when it's nice outside. I painted my bike colorful. fields. You see, they don't have so many. Like this huge forest. They have very wide field. See? There's a sea. Many boats here. And in Denmark, all the education system is for free. So there are so many students from all around the world, even from USA. They come to study at universities to finish their masters, because universities, yes, very high-tech laboratories and programs. See, this country has so many small towns that makes it beautiful. I really love, but the climate is like sea climate, so the skies here are so beautiful, especially if you go to north in the point where to meet cross each other meets each other. It's Baltic Sea and North Sea, and you can see that line where it connects to each other. So the waves splashes to each other, and the water concentration is different. So the colors of the water, you can see the difference. Baltic Sea is more light, and the North Sea is more darker. It's very safe here, at least in my city. Beach house. Probably the people who live in USA are very interested to visit Europe. I would like to visit the same ones as well. I don't like the places that are crowded with many people, because it makes me stressful, because I'm used to live in cold places. And for me, it's to live in big cities, like, I just can't handle it. I'm about to try. Of course. If you want to see that really, how to say, really wealthy economically and culturally side of the Europe is in Denmark. I think this is the best example of what you can ever have of Europe. It's expensive, but it's really worth it. I went to Copenhagen a few times, and I really liked it. Not because there's so many people, but it has some kind of challenges. And next time, after coming back from Athena. I'm not going to do a video in Athena because I won't carry my old stuff there. But I will bring some books of my home country that I really love. I really would like to show you. See, the atmosphere is so chill. Actually, it's not only about images, it's actually the real life. It is how it is here. It's even colder. Before coming here, I didn't know that this country is so chill. But the more I live, the more I see that you kind of also adapting to the environment and you're becoming more like relaxed and you just don't rush somewhere and just mentality some kind of changes in a way. Because in my country, home country, everyone is just rushing. So, such a beautiful street. And it's everywhere like this, especially in the main streets. Maybe I will find a picture of the city. Is written in there also. Minimalistic and also more vintage, and we call it hygge. Hygge, it means the things that makes you feel cozy. So all the promotion of this culture is based on hygge, and I find it really lovely. I mean, whenever you go, either it's coffee, either it's a restaurant, or it's a place for students to chill, to drink the coffee, to play board games. Anywhere. You find these small details, they're so cozy and beautiful. And I mean, like, I don't know, it's like you're chilling and you're feeling like, I don't know how to describe it. But I think I can get the book about hygge, or if you're interested, you can read it about it and watch some videos or images. This is the amusement park in Copenhagen. It's a very old one. I'm not sure, but yeah, I went there once and wow, were just amazing. Like, so many theories and old these riots and carousels. I mean, like, all the atmosphere. And it's not so expensive. I don't know how much it is. I don't know how much in dollars, but it's not so expensive. And you get all the tickets to ride for free. Look at those streets. Especially I love the winters here in October, because then all the hygge becomes vibrant. Also, Denmark is well known as the farmer's land, so all the production of meat is the main focus of the country, so we don't really import from our countries because we have everything by themselves, the local market. This is terminal. This is Copenhagen Airport, I guess. It's a huge airport. Not as huge in USA. Going to that small country. It's crazy that such a small country has such a strong and all the system. It's going to the beach from time to time because from us it's just 30 kilometers. So we have a chance to visit. Summer in Denmark, there's a lot of tourists, especially in Copenhagen. Everyone they come from all around the world. And the races, horse races. I mean, like, you should see so many people. People own these classic cars, like these American cars from 50s, from 40s, from 60s, and it's crazy, like, to see like so many old people riding those cars. So much care we have to put in these cars, and they have even markets there. They have even the huge market where we're selling the parts for these cars, and we even make an exposition of them. So yeah, so I love this car. I really enjoy looking in the northern sky. Yeah, it's not northern, but north sky. Especially there, the place where we live, you can see such a beautiful sky. And when it's almost the night, you can see that color. I really love it. Still okay? I hope you enjoy this video. I hope I made Denmark really appealing to you, because I actually like this. And if you have any ideas of which videos to make, because I'm kind of sometimes I'm just lacking of inspiration, because for me it seems that this video I already made, this one I made, I need something new, and sometimes just this inspiration doesn't come, so I'm not uploading or doing anything. So for now I took this book from library, and I have other few books that I could flip, but if you will tell me what kind of videos you would like to see, just write below the comments or just write me a message and I will read it through. But yeah, thank you for watching again, and have a nice night or day. See you.